Hello friends, welcome back to the lecture series of communication system. In this lecture I am going to discuss about the pulse time modulation. So basically pulse time modulation or PTM is divided into two parts. First is called pulse width modulation and second is pulse position modulation. So what is the definition of the pulse width modulation? In the case of the pulse width modulation, width of the pulse carrier wave. It means I am discussing about the carrier. Width of the pulse carrier varies in accordance with the instantaneous amplitude of modulation signal. It is called pulse width modulation. Here amplitude and position of the pulse is constant. Only the width of the pulse is varied. Similarly, the pulse position modulation, constant width pulse are used. It means pulse width is constant. And the position or time of occurrence of each pulse from some reference time is made directly proportional to the amplitude of the information signal. It means in any pulse, it's the amplitude, its position and its width. They are the three parameters to characterize a pulse or to draw a pulse. So, if its width is varied, then it is the pulse modulation. All other parameter is constant. And if its position is varied with some reference, because once we have varied the position, we require a reference point. With this reference point, we are able to identify the position of the different pulses. Then it is called the pulse position modulation. So these are the basically definition of the pulse width and pulse position modulation. Then we have discussed about the pulse width modulation. Again, we are using a modulating signal, that is a simple information signal, and it is passes through a pulse signal. In the case of the pulse width modulation, we use a sawtooth generation, because in the case of the sawtooth generation, variation of the width is possible. And then after this, when it passes through the adder circuit and then it passes through the slicing circuit, is the output is pulse width modulated output. It is a basically the block diagram. See here in this circuit, actually here I am forget to draw the sawtooth waveform. Then it is very clear how we got this width. See here, the width is large in comparison to the pulse, this pulse. If you compare the width of this pulse and this pulse, it is the larger than this, it means smaller width is in that case. And then see here these lines, actually these lines are drawn on the basis of the sawtooth waveform we have used. So on this basis we convert this modulating signal into the pulse width modulated waveform. See here, this is the basically we use a 555 timer. This particular 555 timer is our work in A stable and a mono stable system. So here it work in a A stable manner. Here it is basically in a mono stable manner. So it's in the case of the one pulse, it provides one output. In the case of the second, it provides the second output. It means output of this particular 555 timer is the pulsed output, and then if 555 timer is applied to this, and this particular circuit is work as an integrator. So this particular is work, it means this particular pulse is converted into a sawtooth waveform type of the pulse with the help of this particular circuit, and then it is passes in this cell. And this particular op amp is work as a A stable multi vibrator, and the width of this particular integrator decide this width of this particular pulse. So here we got a pulse width modulated output. Advantage: pulse width modulation system is more immune to noise in comparison to the pulse amplitude modulation. And the second is synchronization. We can easily synchronize pulse width modulation. It means generally synchronization is not required. It is possible to separate out signal from the noise. And the application of the pulse width modulation is a special purpose communication system, basically it is in a military operation, but it is rarely used in commercial digital transmission system. So these are the basic. It means pulse width modulation system is mostly used for the military purpose, not for the commercial purpose. Then we move to pulse position modulation. See this particular circuit. Till a slicing circuit, our block diagram is same. Output of this slicing circuit is a PWM signal. It passes to a differentiator, then it becomes a pulse position modulation. See here the circuit. This circuit, it our modulating signal. It is converted into a pulse width modulated output. Then this it is passed through a differentiator. So the differentiator, due to the differentiator, we got a pulse type of the waveform. And this width of this pulse type of waveform, we are able to generate the pulse position modulation. See here, actually this particular blank part, we generate a pulse in these outputs. And with this help, we are able to generate a pulse position modulated output. It means pulse width modulated signal is actually converted into pulse position modulated signal. So these are the method. So if you are seeing the, what are the advantage of the PPM signal, it also have the good noise immunity. Second, it require a constant power output. So these are the basically advantages of the pulse position modulated signal. If you move into the disadvantage, it requires synchronization. Similarly, it requires large bandwidth. And then we move to the application. So it is used for optical communication system, and it is used for narrowband FM channel allocation, especially in the radio control and model aircraft, boats and car. PPM is also used for military application. Then see this particular diagram, how we generate this PPM signal. So here it is the pulse width modulated circuit, and we have already studied about this pulse width modulated. Its output is passed through this particular circuit, so it integrated this output, and then after passing through this particular 555 timer, it work in a A-stable mode, so it produces output that is equivalent to the pulse position modulation. Once you study about the IC555 timer, then you know what is the working of A-stable mode and mono-stable mode of 555 timer. And once you have clear about how this behavior of this IC in A-stable and mono-stable mode, you are able to understand how it convert a PWM to PPM, how it convert a pulse width modulated outputs. So these are the basic circuit that used for the generation of the PPM signal. Then we have a next slide. In this slide we compare about the PAM, PWM and PPM. If its parameter is variable, parameter of pulse carrier. So in the case of, if the pulse carrier is our parameter, then PAM amplitude is vary, PWM width is vary, and PPM position is vary. If we are parameter is bandwidth requirement, so the bandwidth is lowest in the case of PAM and highest in the all the other cases. It means PWM and PPM. Similarly, if our parameter is the transmitted power, so the PAM transmitted power varies with amplitude of the pulse, PWM varies with variation in the width, and PPM transmitted power is remain constant. So that is one of the advantage. Here in the third case, transmitted power is a constant. Then the noise immunity is high in PWM and PPM cases and low in PAM cases. Then information, here the information is contained in amplitude. Here in the second case it is contained in the width, in the third it is contained in the position, and the output waveform is look like this. So if you see here, it is very clear that PAM signal noise immunity is low, that's why PAM signal is rarely used, and PWM and PPM signal have high noise immunity, so it is maximum use. Second, its bandwidth requirement is high, and that is the one of the reason We mostly use PWM and PPM signal in the military application. Why? Because its noise immunity is the high. Similarly, our PPM signal is also used in optical fiber communication. Communication because there the bandwidth is available. In the case of optical fiber, high bandwidth is available, so we can be able to use the PPM signal. PPM pulse position modulated modulation is able to use in the case of optical fiber. So these are the basically variation, and that is the all about the PAM, PWM and PPM. It means in this lecture we study about the pulse amplitude modulation, pulse position modulation and pulse width modulation, its advantage, its disadvantage and its application. In the next class we are going to discuss about the pulse code modulation. Thanks for your attention.